While in the middle of a stressful conversation, our two boys were swept up from the streets faster than light. Startled, they glanced in all directions. Yet they only found the wind in their hair, cars flashing by, and an unwelcome yet beautiful face. Mother Mairest. Heh. Hi, Mom.
Miss my sweet little boy. We've been all so worried about you.
I'm okay, I swear.
Darling, you know how Mama worries. You've had your fun, but I think it's time to come home, don't you?
Mom, I... No.
But honey, I need a yes.
3, 2, 1, go!
You see how ridiculous this is, don't you?
What do you mean?
Well, it's obvious. The little boy has had his mind tainted by that pest. Filling your head with all kinds of lies.
You whore. All I've ever done is love and care for him. That's more than your or your monster of a husband can say. Pico.
Snip it. There is nothing wrong with our family. Love you so much. Why don't you just come with me?
I'm sorry, Mom. I'm not going with you.
That way.
3, 2, 1, go!
enough of this. I have tried and tried and tried to make you see what a mistake you're making. Clearly, you're too stupid to see that.
Stop.
Better drop this act and learn how to respect this mother this instant. Or else.
Okay, I've had enough of this, softy.
Silence, vermin. You can't decide things for him.
She's right. What? I have to decide for myself. And I've decided to live the life I want to live.
You've always been such a pathetic excuse for a son.
3, 2, 1, go!
Selfish little brat. I'm gonna make you regret ever thinking you had a choice in all this.
Softy! Huh? Jump! Babe, I love you. But we are on top of a moving car! Are you crazy? Do you trust me? Do you trust me? Yes? Then on the count of three, close your eyes and jump. One. Wait a minute. Two. Isn't there like a plan B or something we could try? Three.